They say more money, more problems. They say more money, more problems. Bring on the problems. Hey everybody, welcome to Trading Capital's exclusive analysis. Right now we're going to be touching base on the NASDAQ and why I think there's more downside to come. Overall, the NASDAQ had a bounce off of the support level, as you can see, hitting the support here. Being the fact that the NASDAQ has now been rejected at resistance, it is likely that we still see a retrace back down to this overall trend line. So that would imply about a 2.5% drop, basically, that could happen on the NASDAQ. And after today's bearish price action in the overall indices, especially late on in the session, I think what could take the NASDAQ down to this level is if we see continued weakness in NVIDIA. Obviously, we're net short NVIDIA right now, so we're expecting continued weakness. But ultimately, the NASDAQ hasn't really hit the big area that it needs to defend to really see if this market rally has any more upside and momentum to continue the upward trend. Overall, based off of where the dollar is moving and where yields are, I still think it's unlikely that these markets really challenge these highs. It's more likely that we basically come back to the lows on the session. Touching base on a couple charts, AMC was a big winner for us today. We closed an 11.15% win. It did dip in earnings on the after hours report there. We were able to cover in the pre-market hours, so great job on that. And then just to put into perspective, there's a lot of interesting charts appearing. I mean, you look at Pfizer. Pfizer has been demolished, clearly putting in potentially a little bit of a reversal signal over here. But look at this epic fall on Pfizer. That is a thing from grace. It's really, really interesting to watch. And then if we look at the total crypto market, so the total crypto market cap is still holding that trillion mark. I still think that if we lose that $1 trillion status, that's when you could likely see a bigger move down, likely coming back down to this support around 954. And then ultimately, I do think on the larger term basis for the crypto market cap, you still have to really retrace back to this downsloping trend line to see if the bulls really have momentum to continue this trend higher. But ultimately, it's still technically put in a little bit of bullish consolidation. You can see that the 50 daily moving average has caught up to the overall price action. So that is a short-term positive, but you really don't want to lose this price action. And considering that you're putting in minor bear flag pattern over here, it does mean that Bitcoin is slightly susceptible, or the overall crypto market cap is slightly susceptible to rolling over in the near term. But if you just scroll through a lot of the mega caps, Apple was down today, Microsoft was down, Amazon was up, Google was up, Tesla was down. Tesla has a big day tomorrow with the investor conference coming up. Basically, if Tesla poops the bed, so to speak, then we could see these markets in for a harder sell-off, because it certainly looks like the way NVIDIA closed that we're likely to see more downside. So if Tesla obviously doesn't hold up its end of the bargain, I think that's where we could see the NASDAQ running into a lot of trouble in the near term. Really, that's going to sum it up for the tech space. If we look at natural gas, I mean, it has been a powerhouse. We talked about the simple retrace, which we actually got intraday. Let me just blow up this chart to show you what transpired. Basically, this has been the epic rally in natural gas. You got a small pullback. Notice where you retraced to, back to these original pivot zones, and then natural gas really hasn't looked back. So with this type of price action in natural gas, it's likely that this locomotive freight train has left the station. Maybe that was the last little buying opportunity. Maybe we get one more retrace back to support. I was still optimistic that we could see maybe a potential retrace to this level to potentially accumulate a long. But you can see that it just missed it there with the tail. I was actually waiting to accumulate more at that level, but the algos definitely didn't let us get an accumulation on that level. But nonetheless, we still have a pretty large exposure to UNG natural gas. So I do think that we're likely to get more upside. One of the things I'm going to put on your radar is this beautiful, beautiful monthly bottoming tail. That is a thing of beauty. If you don't know technical reversals, this is probably one of the best ones you could actually look for and learn from. This is a textbook monthly reversal bottoming tail. Doesn't get any cleaner and clearer than that. And typically what this means is you get further upside from here. Now, considering it is a monthly pattern, monthly patterns can and are notorious for having minor retraces. So typically you could get a retrace of about 50%, because there's still going to be a lot of people that don't believe this reversal. So if the market makers manage to retrace a good share of this bottoming tail, it'll likely shake out a lot of those longs who get kind of spooked out of the trade. But I'm going to warn you, do not get spooked out of the trade. I mean, we could even retrace this full bottoming tail back to the 210 level, and it would still be technically bullish. You would ultimately need a monthly close below this to negate this reversal signal. And any retrace, in my mind, is an accumulation opportunity. So don't miss out on this natural gas move. Based off of where the KOLD ETF is trading and what price action just transpired today, extremely bearish, I think it's only prudent that natural gas maybe sees a little bit of minor consolidation. I would love to see a little bit more consolidation before it continues its ascent up, but you never know. A chart that's this beaten down, a chart that could be open up to short squeezing, and especially if you look at if there is exit liquidity coming out of tech, healthcare, and the broad indices, that money or a good chunk of that money often likes to look for depressed assets because there's some active portfolio managers that can't be sitting in cash as part of their mandate. They have to be fully invested at all times in the market. So they look for more of the beaten down sectors that are potentially starting new trends. And this might be starting a new trend to the upside. Taking a look at oil, let's do the USO chart because we haven't touched base on that. But the USO chart, you can see that it clearly came up to the 50 daily moving average once again and got rejected. This is ultimately putting in a bearish wedge that likely is going to break to the downside. Our members obviously know our expectations for oil and what we're doing to potentially catch this trade setup. So on that note, it's just chopping in a wedge here. We have to wait for a definitive move, either break up out of this wedge or break down out of this wedge. Right now, it could chop for several more weeks until we get that bigger directional move. Overall, it's been a fantastic month for the Trading Capital members. We have crushed it this month. Just to put into perspective, I am going to put up some of our tradings just so that we can review some of our winners. And let me just adjust my screen here. But just to put things into perspective here, let me just adjust this camera and this screen over here just so we can see a little bit better. And this is the back-end software, so you're kind of getting a little exclusive peek. But just so we can see here, but for the month of February, basically starting here in February 1st over here, we've closed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25 wins, 1 loss, 25, 1 loss, 26 wins, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, and 37, 38, 39, 2 losses, 40 wins, 41, 42 wins, and 2 losses for the month of February swing trading. We have had an outstanding month, by far one of the best, most profitable months year to date, and most likely of my investing career. It has been a stellar month if you have been a TC member. So we're happy to help new people on board and provide access to all of our trade setups and alerts, but it has been fantastic trading the charts. And certainly we look to potentially strive forward and continue to make more profits as the rest of the year progresses. And I do think the volatility is going to likely remain. On that note,